What are the key operational challenges of the glass industry? And what future trends in digital twin technology could further transform glass manufacturing? I'm Asma from Ansys, and you're watching the Twin Talks. To answer these questions, we are joined today by Dr. Hossam Metwally, Senior Principal Application Engineer, and by Dr. Jose Luis Gonzalez, Senior Application Engineer at Ansys. Hossam is leading a team of engineers focusing on chemical, pharma, and consumer goods industries. He has been with Ansys for 23 years, where he has enjoyed different roles in business development, software support and testing, and technical marketing. He obtained his PhD in mechanical engineering from the University of Cincinnati in 2002. Jose Luis has a background in CFD and system level modeling, especially from thermal applications. He works with customers across the globe in supporting their digital twin needs for many industries, including the glass industry. He obtained his PhD from the Rochester Institute of Technology in 2019. Hossam, what are the most significant challenges currently facing the glass industry, particularly in terms of production efficiency and quality control?
Thank you, Asma. Thank you very much for this kind intro and this interesting question, actually. And the way I think about it in terms of glass, really, I like to call the challenges for glass, you know, I call them the glass trifecta, three things. So the glass trifecta basically composed of sustainability, quality, and increased productivity. And let me elaborate a little bit on that. So when it comes to sustainability, specifically for glass, glass is a very unique, you know, material or product when it comes to sustainability. So on one hand, glass is typically reviewed as or viewed as an extremely recyclable material from that aspect. So glass gets a star for that, being recyclable. And also glass or glass-related products are heavily used to aid in sustainability initiatives in terms of high-end insulation materials, for example, and also high-end windows for sustainable buildings. Again, glass gets another star for that. But when we look at the glass manufacturing process, it's actually an extremely energy-intensive process, and which can potentially have a negative impact in terms of energy consumption and carbon footprint, right? And because of that, you know, people are looking into new technologies to reduce this environmental impact, and potentially new technologies also for newer glass manufacturing processes. So that's the sustainability leg of the glass trifecta. The second one is the quality control, or the quality of the glass itself, where, you know, it is coming potentially from new markets that glass is trying to cater to, whether it's in from the high-tech industry, mobile industry, or energy-efficient buildings. Again, these newer, you know, requirements for glass products are pushing the realm for glass quality. And typically, as the glass quality requirements increase, potentially the energy needed to manufacture these high-end products potentially may also increase. Another challenge. And then last but certainly not least, in terms of increased productivity, or sometimes I like to call it agile productivity, where glass potentially, or the product can potentially be produced according to an ever-changing requirements, potentially closer or closest to the final consumer. And this is especially true for container glass industry.
So how are Ansys simulation tools being used in the glass industry to address these challenges?
Again, thank you, Asma, for another great question. So Ansys is actually very well suited to address these challenges. And we have been working with our customers for decades now to work on various steps of the glass manufacturing process. We start all the way from batch preparation and batch feeding into the furnace, for example, okay? And then all the technical challenges can be simulated in the hot end, like, you know, combustion or melting of glass, the glass delivery process through, for example, four hearts, all the way to glass annealing and heat treatment. All these individual steps have already been simulated using the various Ansys tools with different levels of complexities and different levels of details. And so not just are these individual steps being simulated and have been simulated, but now people are even pushing it further towards optimizing these individual steps and even looking at the overall system level model, as we will also discuss today.
Jose Luis, digital twins are becoming increasingly important across various industries. How do digital twins integrate with traditional simulation tools in the glass industry, and what additional value do they bring?
Hello, Asma. Hello, Hossam. Thank you for the introduction. That's a very good question. Indeed, the Ansys offering for digital twins is very relevant because we can create digital twins from a model coming from different sources, for example, traditional CFD tools like the flagship solvers we have, or system level modeling like Hossam mentioned. And further, like the cherry on top of the cake, is that we can enhance this type of models with operational data in what we call hybrid digital twins. This is very important because now with these hybrid digital twins, the predictions that the digital twins are making can reflect much better the current state of the asset or process being analyzed. One of the key enables for this is our ability to create fast running models, or we call them reduced order models. And we have different techniques and methods to create this type of technology. Also, our digital twins can be deployed in different ways. This is very valuable because they can communicate with sensor data coming from their equipment in these industries. And then they can. The customers are now able to make more informed decisions, given the current information that they are getting from the sensor and the predictions and the additional information they can get from our digital twins. Specifically for the glass industry, digital twins can be used to monitor the entire production process. This can go all the way from raw materials, the input of them, to the final product output. Also, by integrating data from the sensors and aligning them with simulations, companies can predict issues before they happen. This is very valuable because now they have they can have predictive models to take more informed decisions, to understand what will happen if they continue running that way, and then how they can optimize the process. Our digital twins have been used very widely as a virtual sensors because they are built from physics-based models, so they can get information that may not be available through physical sensors. So our twins can complement the information that they can get. Our twins can also offer performance prediction in real time of quantities that may be very relevant for them, like process temperature. Thank you.
So can you just explain how digital twins are being used for predictive maintenance, system configuration, and production optimization within the glass industry?
Sure. That's a good question, Asma. Generally, our Ansys digital twins are created from physics-based model. This aids in exploring the design space much quicker without having the need to prepare probably complicated or expensive tests to run. Everything can run in a virtual environment. So this also avoids running the equipment in probably harsh conditions. Customers may need to gather information in regions near failure, for example, then having a virtual model that can predict this type of conditions using first principles is very valuable for them as well. With our twins, scenarios that are hard to obtain, or probably problems that may have a high number of parameters can be explored with simulation. And as I mentioned before, with models that run closer than real time and preserve the high fidelity from simulations, they can have the confidence of the predictions they are making are accurate, in addition to being very fast. They can get remaining useful life type of predictions, so they can know, okay, if I continue running this way, then I will need to do maintenance around this time frame. This is very important to help them to reduce unplanned downtime, which can be a challenge in all industries, not only in glass industry. So they can increase the reliability of their processes, and as well as the quality of their products, because they can monitor what's happening in real time. Specifically of our Ansys digital twin offering for the glass industry, we can create very accurate virtual models of their production system. This typically have used the power of the Ansys simulation tools. If they have existing models, that we can help them to reuse the models they have, so they don't need to start from scratch. Use their high fidelity simulations to create models that will run much faster, or reduce order models using a variety of tools that we have. Then by integrating this type of models with probably other models, or integrating different ROMs to create an assemble of components, they can get more informed decisions. For example, if they change a parameter in the operation, they can understand how the whole system will react much faster, which is very important. And one of the key drivers for this is sustainability, as Hossam mentioned.
And Jose Luis, how do you see the adoption of simulation tools and digital twins evolving in the glass industry?
Yeah, that's a very relevant question, Asma. In my opinion, I see that glass manufacturing companies are relying more on simulation, mainly driven by the trifecta that Hossam mentioned, and also the need to have faster times to market to increase their competitiveness. Also, digitalization is an important driving factor. The number of digital twins that are being used in the field has increased considerably over the past years, and I think these trends will hold in the future. Probably will even increase further. By using our Ansys digital twins, customers in the glass industry are unlocking additional value. This translates to more efficient processes, reduced time to market, also reduced maintenance cost, and higher quality products. I think that in summary, taking into account all of these conditions, the combinations of Ansys CFD tools and Ansys digital twins provides the glass industry with a very comprehensive approach to overcome the main challenges they are facing.
Hossam, what future innovations can we expect that might positively impact glass manufacturing?
Thank you, Asma. Again, you know, I love this question because it contains two of my favorite words, future and innovation. And that's, you know, combining the two is always, you know, something very exciting for me. So first, I think, you know, with the push of renewables, I think, you know, renewable energy specifically, I think electric melting specifically will have a bigger role to play when it comes to glass. And, but I think it will also come with its own challenges, because we will be dealing with electric power or electric powers, currents and voltages at rates that are unprecedented for sure. And again, the challenge there is, how can this even be handled, controlled and optimized? And, you know, again, you know, this would bring us back to the what we started with, making, you know, this problem even more of a multi-physics problem. And I think, you know, electric engineers will definitely have a much bigger role to play, believe it or not, when it comes to glass manufacturing than before. Similarly, I think new and alternative melting technologies will continue to be developed when it comes to glass. So, for example, hydrogen and hydrogen-blended fuels, I think, will have a role to play when it comes to glass melting. And, you know, hydrogen-blended fuels, for example, you know, one can envision them slowly displacing fossil fuels and thus reducing carbon footprint that fossil fuels are, you know, having as part of the glass manufacturing process. Now, obviously, hydrogen itself comes with its own challenges in terms of how it can, how it is produced, transported, and stored. So all these are, you know, interesting technical challenges that will need and are currently being worked on, by the way, on getting resolved, and they will have an impact on the glass manufacturing process. And then last but certainly not least, AI and ML. And I think, you know, everybody is now talking, you know, trying to really understand the impact of artificial intelligence and machine learning. And I think we are already entering the age of big data. And with the, where is this data coming from? I guess we can actually pause. Well, obviously, you know, this big data, as Jose Luis mentioned, can potentially have two streams, right? One stream is simulation, and the amount of data through simulation is increasing at an exponential rate, thanks to high-performance computing, GPU computing, and cloud. And as more and more data is being generated through simulation, and as AI and ML techniques getting smarter and smarter, you know, we are actually entering into a very interesting, you know, a spectrum of how engineers can potentially use this wealth of information that is, you know, being continuously generated and coming up with new designs and new manufacturing processes, actually, that, you know, will again, will be able to, you know, to resolve the glass trifecta that we started with in terms of sustainability, production, and quality. Now, again, as Jose Luis mentioned too, the stream of data is not just simulation, but it's also field data. And then again, both streams are really feeding into the AI ML you know, spectrum. So I think really we're entering into a very interesting age where, you know, the amount of data is exploding, and how can we actually make use of them to address our engineering challenges? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Hossam and Jose Luis, for being part of this new episode of the Twin Talks, discussing the glass industry challenges and digital twins.